They have been used for many centuries and often associated with good storytelling tactics. They can add a lot of excitement to stories, or they can leave the listener feeling frustrated. They are called cliffhangers. Welcome to Radical Thought. Today's radical question is, why is a cliffhanger necessary? Cliffhanger is a device used to ignite curiosity in literature. The first recorded incident of a cliffhanger being used is mentioned in the book Arabian Nights, or 1001 Arabian Nights, written in 1704. This book is a collection of folk tales from Arabia, Persia, Turkey, India, and China. What is common throughout all the stories of the book is the initial famed story of the ruler Shahryar and his wife Shahrazad, and the framing device incorporated throughout the tales themselves. The stories proceed from this original tale. Some are framed within other tales while others are self-contained. There are two versions of this main story, but the more famous one goes like this. King Shahryar was betrayed by his first wife and left him heartbroken. After that, King Shahryar married a new girl every day and had her executed the next morning, possibly to avoid betrayal. He had already killed 3,000 women in this way. 3,000 women mean 3,000 days, which is a little over 8 years. For 8 years, he kept up this brutality. One day, a woman called Shahrazad, meaning world freer, heard about this continuous act from her father, who was the royal advisor to that king, and coincidentally was responsible for providing him a new bride every night. She asked her father to present her as the next bride. Her father disagreed, but she eventually convinced him. She spent all night telling him a story. At the end of the night, she stopped the story at an exciting moment. The king wanted to hear the end of the story, but Shahrazad said that he would have to wait until the next night to hear the rest. The next night, she finished the story and began another one, which she again stopped when it was dawn. The king had to wait another night to hear the rest of the story. Shahrazad kept this up for 1001 nights. She told him 1001 stories. In the end, the king had fallen in love with Shahrazad, and they already had 3 children, so he did not have her executed. Now, Shahrazad may have done this to save her own life, as well as many other women, but this is how the cliffhanger was invented as a curiosity device in literature. By nature, man is a curious creature. We want to know something that is hidden from us. Why? Because our mind continuously wanders about what will come next. This anticipation of what will come next is something we relish, and also feeds our precognitive ability. Cliffhangers in any form of literature appeal to our curiosity. The main purpose of employing this device is to maintain suspense in the plot, in order to ensure the interest and focus of the reader. It acts as bait to lead the audience from one part of the story to another with more interest than before. Cliffhangers undoubtedly are enjoyable at the end of movies. However, it can be very frustrating at the very end of a novel, as it leaves the readers discontented after all the effort they put in to read the novel. In TV series, where the cliffhanger tool is perhaps the most popular, they make use of this device to great effect. The viewers' favorite characters are left in a lurch, and the viewers yearn to know more about their fate. As a result, viewers are likely to want to keep up in the next episode. A modern version of a cliffhanger is called a stinger. This is a small clip that is shown during the end credits of a movie to trigger interest about a possible sequel of that movie. So what do you think? What is your favorite cliffhanger from all-time literature? How did it make you feel? Comment below. If you like this video, please like and share. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe so every new video reaches you immediately. So, with an exciting new radical question, see you in the next episode.